please locate the British Museum on Great Russell Street, London, United Kingdom?
Yes, we have this.
On display here is a piece of round or slightly oval-shaped rock crystal unearthed in modern-day Iraq, called the Nimrud lens, or layered lens. Please locate this, the Nimrud lens.
Yes, we have this.
Briefly, what was this artifact used for?
Somewhat of a magnifying glass, but more of that as to a transistor of light, where, like any oval shape, it would focus the rays of the sun on a specific area. This was part of a device to cause heating, but also as a signaling device, where, like a modern-day lighthouse, it could be moved in such a way as to cause light to be shone at great distances. But it had a dual purpose here. It was also used to heat water, and even to a point of such heat could melt copper, you'll see. We have it here in various configurations over time. But its original purpose would be to be used as focusing the sun rays and to use it like a weapon, shining into or upon invading forces a great intensity of light, like a magnifying glass. They would cause paper to ignite. Its primary purpose, you'll see, as a signaling device, and then more on occasion to be used as somewhat of a device to heat water, although this was not as a utility, but used more like a ceremonial exemplification of the concentration of light. Direction. Time is getting short.
You mentioned it was used as a signaling device. Who or what would be signaled there? Groups of people, like an army, or what circumstances do you see it used as a signal?
This would be as to a gathering of peoples. It would be shone at great distances, and it would be focused on mirrors or reflective surfaces at great distances. When there would be a signal, then it would be a collection of peoples to come to the center point, you'll see. The rallying of armies, or that of the ceremonial yearly events of celebration of the new year, a signal of when to plant crops, where there would be need to send out a signal occasionally. But that it would be seen as a rallying or signal to draw people to the central point for religious services or for times of conflict or on other occasions as to the timing of seasonal activities, you'll say. As any would use a signaling device to attract people at long distances, you'll say. For it was an extreme concentration of light, and it doesn't seem to be the only one that was in existence at the time. Direction.
Thank you. And lastly, who do you see created this object, and when?
Those it would be as to the Ottoman Empire. Those it would be the discoverer of glass. We have the name as to Admal Kutzpur, who would be somewhat of the craftsman, you'll see, along with a few workers. It would be the grinding of what would be found as a natural shape of glass under the sand. For glass exists here in great sheets under the sand. And as such, this was seen as some, at first, presentation from the heavens above, but then it was found to be a directional item of light. There was some continued experimentation, and telescopes were developed from this as well. Look back and you would find some references here to various curved lights, rather curved glass that would cause light to be manipulated. And even that as a prism being discovered, they would fractionate light, you'll see. This would be great in the understanding of what light was, but it would be considered of a religious perspective as to the giver of life, as to light being necessary for life, but also it could be concentrated, and there you would have even that would relate to the Ark of the Covenant, some mysteries as to the concentration of light. However, light was used as a weapon, as a tool, and it helped to understand the difference between electricity, gravity, and magnetism. It is all frequency, and you would find that of references on tombs in Egypt, of those devices that would look like fire hoses, with light coming out the end. The manipulation of light, the concentration of light, is seen in the present-day world as laser. This is the understanding they had in Baghdad and other places at that time. However, it all started with a piece of glass that was honed or shaped into a shield, which ultimately became a lens, which ultimately became the conductor of light. How to shine it, how to concentrate it, and how to use it. And at that time, it was considered high technical, or high technology rather. And those who understood the same were revered and given great prominence in the society. See, we finished for the present.